All right.
I'm at the former residence of our 45th president, a guy named Donald Trump. Ever heard of him?
And he lived here 1984 until 2017, where, of course, he moved into the White House, and now he's lives down in Mar-a-Lago. And, yeah, just going to do a walkthrough. I'm at the corner of 5th and 56th Street. I'm going to try to cross here. Yeah, and let's see, the top three floors were his penthouse suite, and his office was the 26th floor, and it looks over Central Park, which is kind of that way. You've got Tiffany's next door. And the bottom three floors, the atrium, is public. You can walk in, so I'm going to do a walk around, and this is the main entrance. The residential entrance is to the right. And going up to the 26th floor are corporate offices. It's a multi-use building. And then from the 27th floor to the top are residential. And I can tell you, former residents, Bruce Willis had a 15-room apartment inside. Michael Jackson rented a place at one time. Like I say, the residential entrance is down there. Andrew Lloyd Webber had three places in here. Also, Cristiano Ronaldo, I think that's his name, soccer star, has a place in here, or had a place in here. And, yeah, as you might know, he likes to put his name on everything. Everything's in gold.
Here it is. Trump Grill. But our bar upstairs.
Starbucks. And there's where a lot of the celebrities would go up to his office. And this 40-foot wall here normally has water coming down. It's like a waterfall. And you might recognize these famous escalators when he came down. Trump store, Trump cafe, grill, boutique, bar, and a Starbucks. Tiffany's right over there.
And when this was completed, it was the tallest glass covered structure in the world.
The grill's open. Trump Suites. And the
Trump store. Over here are all this, a bunch of their properties, the Trump Corporation, and down there is Charlottesville, the winery. And so we're in the Trump Tower. This is the Trump World Tower. And it's kind of behind the Chrysler Building going toward the East River. It's larger than this one. Oh, and they own 40 Wall Street. That was the tallest building in the world, right before the Chrysler Building. And they were building about the same time, and they kept going back and forth, going higher and higher. So finally, the Chrysler Building kept their mouth shut, let 40 Wall Street finish. And then the Chrysler Building put that big spire on the top, kind of cheating, but so they took the crown. And they were, Chrysler Building was number one until the Empire State Building was finished. And there's a little souvenir shop back here. It's reasonably priced for New York City. Down here, just the bathrooms, and yeah, there's that 40 Wall Street building in Mar-a-Lago. Mar-a-Lago was originally his winter residence while he stayed up here, but now he lives there full time. Oops, zoomed in too far. And that's a rank he built in New York. All right, guys, that's going to be it for Trump Towers, and getting out of here. See ya.